Hello everyone, welcome to the 21st video of the Titanic solution series. In this particular video, we're going to solve the Titanic competition problem statement using tpot. Now what is tpot? Tpot stands for tree-based pipeline optimization tool. Consider tpot your data science assistant. Basically, this helps you to figure out what sort of tree-based algorithms you could use for your problem statement. Now, tpot is a Python automated machine learning tool that optimizes machine learning pipelines using genetic programming. Now, there's a lot of stuff that you can learn about it. Just Google about it and you'll find a lot of details about it. But now let's focus on solving the same Titanic problem using tpot. We're going to begin by importing pandas as PD. Then from tpot, I'm going to import the tpot classifier. This will help us solve a binary classification problem. Then from model selection, I'm going to import train, test and split. I'm going to run it. I'm going to import the train and test data set. These two data sets, we have already done the missing value treatment and feature engineering. So we're just going to import them and directly solve the problem on top of it. I'm going to take my X and Y variables. Y should be survived. X variable should be everything else apart from passenger ID and survived. So I've taken all of these X and Y variables. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my train data set and split it into train and test. This particular code helps me do that. Now it's done. And now I can finally be ready to run the auto ML with tpot. So we begin by declaring a tpot classifier with verbosity is equal to 2 and max time minutes is equal to 10. This means that this particular tpot classifier will run for 10 minutes and within 10 minutes, it'll try to give us what is the best algorithm that it has figured out under that 10 minutes. Now, what's verbosity 2? Verbosity 2 is basically how much information tpot communicates while it's running, right? So when it's running, it'll start to communicate some information and we'll see how that is going to happen. Now, 0 is equal to none, 1 is equal to minimal, and 2 is equal to high, 3 is equal to all. Now, with this particular high, basically it's going to communicate a lot of information. All becomes too much, so we're just going to choose 2 for this particular setting, right? Now, with 2, you'll see that there is a progress bar that helps us know how that particular algorithm is doing. For this particular video's purpose, what I'm going to do is I'm going to run it for 1 minute so that we can see what's happening under 1 minute, right? So I'm just going to keep the max time mins is equal to 1. Obviously, if you set it for 10, it's going to be for 10 minutes. But for this particular video, I'm just going to do it for 1 minute and see what's going to happen there. I, you know, created one instance of it. And now let me run the fit method on the train data set and let's see what happens. Now, this is much like how we do fit in sklearn machine learning algorithms. This is going to be very similar to what we do in sklearn algorithms. So let's run it and see what's happening. So I've run the code. Now the optimization program started. It's saying 27% complete and you'll see that it's trying to do 100 such algorithms and get the best out of it, right? And this one indicates that it's trying to execute so many pipelines per second. So it's roughly around 22 seconds right now. Now another 30 seconds are left. So basically if this 100 is exhausted, what will happen is it will choose another 100 and start executing on top of that, right? So now you'll see another 100 got selected and it's going to run till the time becomes 1 minute. Another 25 seconds, another 15 seconds left. Let's wait for the final outcome to come. Okay, so when the outcome has come, you'll see that it's basically, you know, there are a lot of parameters that are there within it. Now let's see what the score for the train and the test accuracy looks like. So if I run it, you'll see that the test accuracy is around 0.96 and the train accuracy is around 0.84. Sufficiently good for a base problem statement. And let's see which of that algorithm did the best. Right? So I'm going to export that pipeline. Tpot has an export feature, which will export the best one for this particular scenario. So I run it and it'll export this particular file. Let me just open this particular file now. Okay, so I've opened the file from the exported location and this is what it looks like, right? So it's going to import the necessary libraries that are required. Then it's going to also give a generic path location that the user needs to fill in and any separator that's required. Then it's also going to, you know, divide or drop the target variable and divide it into test and train data set in its own way. Then this pipeline is what it will generate, and you will see that the make pipeline has a standard scaler. Random forest classifier is what's used in this particular scenario, right? Bootstrap is equal to true, criterion entropy, max feature is 0.95, and so on and so forth. These are the hyperparameters that are chosen by this particular algorithm for random forest classifier. And notice that, you know, in the previous videos, you will see that in random forest, we got roughly around n estimators under 100. And so far, this tpot algorithm has also figured out that this is going to be a good number for solving this particular problem statement. Obviously, it's going to fit that particular thing, and it's going to predict and store the results in this particular scenario, right? So it does a neat job in terms of executing through and through this problem statement. So I'm just going to close this now. We're going to predict using the best algorithm that was generated by tpot. Okay, and I'm going to export that particular CSV file. I take the test file, drop the passenger ID from it, predict, and then I'm going to create a CSV file that we can submit to Kaggle competition. So I've exported it. So let me go to Kaggle and submit the predictions there. I'm going to take the exported file that is there, and I'm going to put it here. It's going to take some time to upload it. Okay, once it's done, I'm going to say make submission. Now, once it's submitted, you'll notice that the score that this particular algorithm generated was around 0.78468, right? Now, which is a decent score considering the journey we have taken, right? So far, we could generate till 0.7879 using random forest, right? But with this particular case, we are also almost reaching that particular score. With this, we have successfully run our first tpot algorithm, or we've gotten a taste of how auto ML looks like using tpot. Thank you for watching this video, guys. If you like this video, please hit the thumbs up button, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel.